that what makes it unique is that it's the only place where you have it all in such a small surface that gives you all the experiences in one. So you have the Amazon, the Andes, the coast, the Galápagos that are unique in all over the world in just one place. So it's very just easy to travel and experience it all. Well, I'm an economist, so I see in tourism like a source of not only social but also economic development, and I do think that the value chain that tourism has is incomparable with all the other sectors. After agriculture, this is the second sector that employs the most people in the world. So we see a lot of potential, and I think Ecuador has a lot to offer. So that is like the perfect match between reaching development and using wisely the resources that we have. Well, Tren Crucero is basically now the star product. It has been growing a lot, so much that we increase our routes. So now we have daily, weekly departures from Quito and from Guayaquil. That is something that was on demand. The occupancy rate of the Tren Crucero goes over 90%. We're packed for the rest of the year. So we see a lot of potential there because it lets you experiment the whole country from the Andes to the coast and see everything, like food, people, landscapes, just like everything in a packed in a 4-day journey. So actually that is very important because I think that one of the things the train did is kind of like recover all the communities were along the road that used to live from the train. And so it brought them to life again, and so now they show what they are, and it has been an important source of income from them. So in that sense it has been also an important project.
Thank you very much, Minister.
Thank you. So there are many things that are happening in Ecuador, and I think the world is starting to notice it. This is also not only that we have a beautiful country, but also that the government somehow discovered or like realized that the importance of tourism for socioeconomic development, and they saw in tourism an important exit in the transformation towards a non-oil economy. And as I always say, if you want to see the priorities of the government, you should see its budget. So when you see the changes in the investment of tourists, you can see what I'm talking about. So by 2006, that is before this government started, the investment in tourists was $6 million. Now it's 60. And so now I'm gonna give you like a brief overview of each of the regions. What is it that do we have, and what are the kind of like new features that we have to offer? And along the Andes, there are like so many activities. You have the old haciendas that has been turned into hotels. There is also, again, all the experience with the food, and there are lots of projects of communitary tourism, crafts, shopping. There is the Otavalos that perhaps you have heard of, so there are lots of artisans. We also have a rehabilitated railway system that it starts in Quito and ends in Guayaquil. So basically you can go all the way down the Andes in this train that was built in 1900. I will tell you a little bit more later. So we have flower farms. There are flowers in Ecuador that are about my size. Not that I'm very tall, but they are like very nice and pretty in the colors, and because we are in the equator, that makes it unique. And the highlights here, well, we have a new airport. It also won a prize at the South America's Best Airport this year. There are recent hotels like Casa de la Ronda, Casa Gangotena. There is also the Quito Tour Bus that is doing an amazing job, so it takes you among the hot spots in Quito. The train, this is something beautiful that you also you can experiment. As I told you, you can start in Quito, you end in Guayaquil, so it's a 4-day journey. You don't sleep in the train, you sleep in different hotels, haciendas. So you get to first taste the food, taste the different places, you go to the different hotels, and you can see how the nature changes. So you start in the Andes, then you go down to the coast. And as I told you, the history of this is amazing because it was tried to build at the end of the 1800s. And it took like 30 years and they couldn't finish it until Eloy Alfaro, one of the presidents, came and said, no, we have to do it because this is the only way to connect the coast with the Andes. So they rehabilitated, like the regenerated, and they basically opened it in 1908. And then by 1997, basically most of the railways were lost and we had like only a small part of the route. And this government decided to invest it because not only it was part of our culture and our history, but it was also, they had the vision that there could be something interesting there. So we invested almost $260 million and basically recovered all the route from Quito to Guayaquil.